Logo designs are the most versatile when they're made in vector format using programs like Adobe Illustrator. It gives the artwork crisp edges that can be scaled to any size without loss of quality. Logos should also be reproducible in a single colour, like black only, and be able to be reversed out of a dark background, so they're usable in all kinds of real-world design situations. That doesn't mean you can't have some fun making a pretty full colour design though, so in this tutorial we'll create the primary design, then produce flat and mono versions for use in specific scenarios. Now usually we'd start out on paper with some sketches to brainstorm the style of the design that would suit the client or business we're designing for, but since we've already decided to go for the trendy folded look, we can jump straight into the fun design phase. So open up Adobe Illustrator and create a new document at any size. Head to the View menu and select Hide Artboard to give yourself a nice large work area to make use of. Select the Rectangle tool and draw a tall shape to represent the first piece of the icon. Press Command and C to copy, then Command and F to paste in front, which could also be accessible from the Edit menu. Grab the Direct Selection tool, then click and drag the lower edge of the duplicated shape towards the right. Hold the Shift key to make sure this path moves perfectly horizontally. Switch to the Normal Selection tool and draw a selection across both objects, then go to Object, Transform and Reflect. Select the Vertical option and press the Copy button to create a duplicate set flipped for the other side. Hold the Shift key and drag the new shape sideways until the points line up. You might want to zoom right in, then turn on Outline Mode from the View menu or the Command and Y shortcut in order to double check the point alignment. The letter M lends itself to simply duplicating those first two shapes and flipping them, but you could also build other icons by extending the layout in different directions using straight or slanted shapes. So let's bring the design to life with a bit of colour. Find a nice palette to work with from colourlovers.com. I'm using one called Earth. I usually just take a screenshot and paste it into the document. Select the first shape, then grab the eyedropper tool and hold Shift while sampling the purple colour. Switch to the stroke setting in the toolbar and clear out the default black outline. Hold the Command key to toggle back to the selection tool to select the second shape. Release the Command key to switch back to the eyedropper. Clear out the stroke and sample the screenshot to give it an orange fill. Repeat the process until the design has a mixture of purple, orange, green and blue, or whatever colours you chose for your design. To really enhance the folded look, we can add some subtle shading to give the design more depth. Turn on Smart Guides from under the View menu. This will make it easier to snap to the existing points and follow the paths. Select the Pen tool and set up a black fill with no stroke. Begin by creating a point in the upper left corner between the purple and orange, then follow the path to the other side of the first shape. Add a point a little way down the first shape, then close the path back at the starting point. Reduce the opacity of this black shape to around 30% from the transparency panel to tone down its impact, leaving a subtle drop shadow effect that lifts the second piece higher than the first. Since this letter M is symmetrical, this shadow shape can be copied, pasted, flipped and positioned on the other side. Draw another shape down between the two middle colours. This time make it a little thinner. It also needs to run upwards in the direction of the third shape. The full colour version of the logo can be enhanced even further with some subtle gradients. Hold the Shift key while selecting all the main rectangle shapes, then press Command and C to copy and Command and F to paste in front. Replace the fills of all these shapes with a black to white gradient from the swatches panel, then change the blending mode to soft light from the transparency panel. Currently the stacking order of the shapes has some unwanted lines where they overlap. Select the last gradient shape that's over the blue section, then use the Command and left square bracket shortcut to send the item backwards until this overlap disappears. Select the orange gradient shape next and repeatedly press the Command and square bracket shortcut until the vertical line of this shape disappears, then do the same with the purple shape. With the first gradient shape still selected, switch over to the gradient tool, then drag a line from the top to the bottom to alter the flow direction. Hold the Shift key to keep this line straight. Alter the flow of the next shape, this time heading diagonally to allow the gradient to run parallel with the shape outline. Once all the gradients have been adjusted, the design has a really vibrant appearance that will be the primary logo that's used for all on-screen purposes. Gradients don't always translate well into print though, so it's always useful to create a flat version of your logo designs that can be used at small scales or on printed material. Draw a selection around the entire design and go to Edit and Copy. Create a new document in CMYK color mode and paste in this graphic. Select and delete all the gradient overlay shapes to transform the design into flat colors. Any colours outside the CMYK gamut will automatically have been converted to a printable hue within the CMYK spectrum, but I like to satisfy my OCD by rounding off the figures to neaten them up. To avoid any potential printing problems, those shadow graphics should ideally be solid colours rather than being a translucent shade of black. Select them all and turn the opacity back up to 100%. Eyedrop the fill colour from the nearest shape, then add an extra 40% of black in the CMYK colour panel, which will replicate the shadow effect but with a solid colour. Copy and paste the graphic into a new document. This one will be the mono version, which will be used for any scenario where it needs to be reproduced in just a single colour. Select all the coloured shapes and change them to pure black. The shading effect can be still somewhat replicated by punching out the shadows from the surrounding shapes. Shift and click the first rectangle and its shadow to select them both, then click the minus front button from the Pathfinder panel. Repeat the process for the other shapes, then select all and click the Unite button to merge the logo into an easily selectable graphic that can be set in any colour against any background. The final result is a cool logo design with a collection of different versions for real-world use. The full colour RGB version looks great with the gradients and shading effects. The flat CMYK version will reprint nicely on everything from business cards to exhibition graphics, and the mono versions can be applied to any background in any colour. So I hope you enjoyed this latest tutorial and picked up a few tips. If you did, be sure to subscribe to the Spoon Graphics YouTube channel for more video tutorials. Head over to my website at spoon.graphics for more written tutorials, free design resources and design inspiration. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one.